Ready or Not is a comedy horror mystery film starring Samara Weaving, Adam Brody, Mark O'Brien, Andy McDowell, Christian Brune, and Nikki Guardagni. It is directed by Matt Bettelini-Olpin and Tyler Gillette. The story is about a young bride named Grace, played by Samara Weaving, who is forced by her in-laws to play a deadly game of survival on her wedding night. Talk about terrible in-laws. Grace is to be married to her boyfriend, Alex Ladomas, played by Mark O'Brien, when he warns her about his crazy family. Now, Grace comes from a modest background, so naturally she thinks the Ladomas family is skeptical about her because they'll see her as a gold digger. After all, the Ladomas family is filthy rich, making a killing in the game industry. But Grace has no idea what she's in for. On her wedding night, Grace finds her new in-laws hunting her down as part of the family's strange and horrific ritual. Since she's now the prey, the unfortunate bride Grace is quickly established to be different from the rest of the Ladomas family. Thankfully, she isn't just a damsel in distress. Instead, she needs to dig deep to find her strength as she switches to survival mode. While we wish we knew more about her character, Samara Weaving makes it quite easy to root for Grace. The Australian actress smoothly walks the thin line between naive vulnerability and determined resolve. She isn't an action hero, but she comes pretty close to being one. If nothing else, Samara Weaving makes a compelling case as a star in the making. She actually reminds me a lot of Margot Robbie, and if this film is anything to go by, she may have equally impressive acting skills. Back to the film, the highly dysfunctional Ladomas family is an interesting bunch, played with glee by a cast up for the challenge. Mark O'Brien is convincing as Alex, who attempts to be the voice of reason, while his brother Daniel, played by Adam Brody, is oddly charming as a man torn between his own sensibilities and family values. Andy McDowell feels slightly underutilized as Becky, their mother, whose true motives keep you guessing. Supporting actors such as Christian Brune and Nikki Guardagni fully embrace their caricaturous roles, and the film is better off for it. At a taut runtime, the suspense barely loses its hold on your attention, a remarkable feat considering the film doesn't venture beyond the Ladomas mansion. Although the sheer size of the mansion isn't fully utilized in elaborate chase scenes, there's still a lot of tension as you wonder where the story will go next, thanks to writers Guy Busick and Ryan Murphy, who don't take too many shortcuts in the storytelling department. On the flip side though, the climax does go off the rails, and the ending may or may not entirely work for you. But it does make you wonder if directors Matt Bettelini-Olpin and Tyler Gillette were holding back in the rest of the film. Now, this is a tough genre to crack, and this duo have managed to put together quite a surprising film that could have easily stumbled on multiple occasions. I bet they'll have more interesting projects on the way soon after this. I'm going with 3.5 stars for Ready or Not. There is enough gore to justify it as a slasher horror flick. And be warned, there are some scenes that aren't for the squeamish or those who get easily grossed out. But the film excels in its dark and often gruesome humor. Its setup is thematically simple, proposing that the rich do lead different lives. The film stays fresh and thoroughly entertaining as it embraces its absurdity while staying focused on its core theme of family. There is some subtext here about the divide between the rich and the poor, and even gender bias that could be read into, but I think this is a film that can easily be enjoyed at face value without reading too much into the nuances if you don't really want to. That said, I thoroughly enjoyed Ready or Not, and I'm pretty sure you will as well. Guys, thanks so much for watching this review. For more film reviews, interviews, and box office stories, keep watching, because if it's entertainment, you'll find it here on E! Now.